This is the self-publishing news for July the 4th, 2022. Yes, happy birthday, America. Thank you so much for joining me on today's news segment, if you will. The very first item coming up in the news comes from the fine folks over at PublishDrive. Now, PublishDrive, come on, Dale. Publisher Rocket. Get with it. Now, Dave, please don't kill me, man. I didn't mean to mix those things up. I will be talking about PublishDrive later on, but Publisher Rocket just sent out an update to let you know if you do have Publisher Rocket currently. It took some hard work, but Rocket now works with both eBooks and Books for Germany. Originally, they only had eBooks. But if you remember, Amazon would not send us German book data. Luckily, our team found a way to connect and we're making it available to you. So if you happen to have Publisher Rocket, you're going to go ahead and select like the little American flag up the top right-hand corner. There'll be a drop down and you'll see a UK flag and you'll see the Germany flag. You can select that and then just go ahead and get all the data that you need. You're no longer limited. This is freaking cool. I'm very excited to see this rollout come on over there. If you want to get your hands on Publisher Rocket, please use my affiliate link at dalelinks.com/rocket. Get it all set up. And by the way, there's a 30-day no fuss, no muss return policy. So if you're not happy with it, you can return it within 30 days. 30 days, folks, not 2 years, 30 days. Alrighty, going further forward here, PublishDrive has got some great news. See, I told you it was coming to PublishDrive. It was just a slip of the tongue, if you will. They have notified us that Kobo now reaches Italian booksellers IBS.it in Libraccio. That means a ton of new readers to reach for indies already distributed to Kobo via PublishDrive. So if you happen to be using Kobo Writing Life to distribute, I'm assuming that IBS.it and Libraccio will also be available for you there. So whether you're using PublishDrive or you're going straight to there you go. All right, and our Chinese ebook stores under PublishDrive now include CEPIEC, I don't know if it's CPIEC, a giant academic library distributor in mainland China. So if it's your intent to try to reach the Chinese market, PublishDrive is one of the ways that you can do that. Alrighty, next item is coming over from the fine folks over at BookFunnel. And even though I'm not a user of their content, I do like reading some of the articles that they put out. And they were talking about the great Mobi migration. Now, if you weren't too privy to the news earlier this year, Amazon pretty much is doing away with Mobi files altogether. Like, they are not going to accept them going forward. If you do already have a Mobi file for a given publication, they're going to go ahead and grandfather that in. But going forward, you're going to need an EPUB or any other thing besides a Mobi. I imagine in due time, we're going to probably look back at Mobi files and just kind of laugh. It's kind of ancient, like a dinosaur. And of course, you could see inside this image, you get the sense that's what they're going for. But now it's official that they are not going to allow you to email a Mobi file to your Kindle e-reader. So this is not just for you, but also for your readers and potentially your advanced reader copy team. So just know that Mobis are going away. So stop formatting them into Mobi, start using EPUB. I would say whoever you use for formatting, make sure you tell them that. And if you're using like software like Atticus or Vellum, then it'll automatically make it into the right documents for you. Moving further forward, this comes from the fine folks over at Reedsy. And good Lord, Ricardo Fayette is just absolutely on fire. I have like five items up inside the news. I had to whittle it down to this one because this is a pretty awesome looking event. I think it's something worth considering, especially if you want to publish a memoir. How to write a memoir with commercial appeal. This is an event hosted by Reedsy, and author Paul Bradley Carr reveals his top tips for creating a memoir that appeals to a wider audience. This is on Wednesday, July 6th at 3 to 4 p.m. Eastern Daytime. I will let you know that anything that is run by Reedsy, there's no gigantic upsell or anything else like that. It's just a fun event that you can kind of sit, learn, and just try to grow. Really love the gang over at Reedsy just for that reason, because they give so much free value. I'll be talking about Reedsy a little bit more in depth in a future broadcast for sure. Oh, here comes a scam alert. I just want to let you know about it. I got into my email inbox this past week, and I had an email from my old pal, Orna Ross. She's the founder of the Alliance of Independent Authors. It's a nonprofit organization based out of the UK that is run by indie authors for indie authors. I've just gushed about them time and again, but that's besides the point. I want to kind of bring people aware to scams that are running through email, and you got to be super, super, super careful. So this is actually what I ended up finding out. I see this email and it says, hey, you know, sorry to bug you, blah, 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 yakety schmackety. There's this woman. She's in need of money. She's in a dire situation. She had like burglary in her house. There was this whole elaborate story. And I go and I read the story on this. But the one thing that kind of threw me off was like, Orin has never asked for anything from me ever, ever. Like, she's just that type of a person. And also it was riddled with like spelling errors and grammatical errors. And like, I don't know if any of you have read any of her emails before, but they're flawless. Flawless. All right. Like, honestly, I couldn't be able to pick these things apart if I tried. So I just kind of scratched my head, kind of going, huh. And then the actual post that was shared inside there, no, I didn't click on the link. I made sure I typed it in by hand to make sure I was going to the right location and it could block out any kind of malware. And it was a .in address. And I'm like, wait, it would probably make sense if this person was a .com, because this was a person who lived in the United States who was needing some money. And so I started scratching my head going, that doesn't make sense. Like, I don't know. And so I go ahead and I dig a little bit more. I click on the email and I see that it comes from a completely different thing than Orna ever sends out an email from. Like, it was an Outlook, you know, address. So anyway, let me summarize this. Before we get to our weekly roundup of ALLi advice, blah, 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 we wanted to let you know about the orna.ross@outlook.com address with the subject line donation for Jane Michelson. Please know that it's not from me, being Orna Ross. Unfortunately, scammers are using her name and ALLi to tout for PayPal donations. Don't open, answer, or engage, and definitely don't donate. The scam appears to be Facebook-based, and rest assured there has been no breach of the ALLi website, database, or subscriber lists. Never crossed my mind, but I'm glad that they dug into it and looked a little bit further into it. And it was funny because Orna and I actually ended up having an exchange of emails, and she was like, hey, by the way, you haven't updated your profile since 2020. And I was like, oh, I've had a few publications since then. But folks, please be wary of any emails that you get in there. Always question, always question. If it seems out of character, then report spam and move on. Speaking of moving on, we're going to go on over here from great news from Kenny Myers over eBookFairs, which, by the way, we're going to be having an interview with Kenny here relatively soon here on the podcast channel. They now officially have the option to get advance reader copies, or some people call them advance review copies. I don't care. It's the same difference. And it shows you the step-by-step authors upload, readers apply, the review, and the review ends. I got to admit to you, and Kenny, please don't kill me on this one right here. I'm still always just a huge supporter of Story Origin, where I've done ARC reviews. But if you are currently using eBookFairs, having that option available to you is kind of nice. And sorry, I have to kind of say something to Evan here, who is the founder of Story Origin. eBookFairs is cheaper per month. So there's something to kind of weigh in on something like that. But go ahead, take a look at their new stuff. By the way, you can set up an account through my affiliate link at dealings.com/eBookFairs. Or if you just want to skip right to finding the news about it, just go over to eBookFairs.com/review and it'll give you all the information that you need. Alrighty, Findaway Voice is just absolutely on fire. And I'm super proud because my buddy MK Williams is actually putting together a full blog series about building a launch team. So going through learning about marketing your audiobooks, you can learn it from one of the best, one of my absolute favorite video content creators, and MK Williams. So take a look at that on the Findaway Voices site. And by the way, I'm going to put all these links inside the description. Kobo Writing Life has got some more news rolling out here with them. They've got a podcast episode coming up with Marcus Talberg, where he's going to be discussing being uniquely you. This is an episode that I think it's something, if you find yourself stuck and you're not sure what you want to be when you grow up, then this might be the podcast for you. Kobo Writing Life, subscribe to their podcast. Really just a wealth of great information. More news coming up here about Laterpress. I've been talking about them here recently, and I promise this is not just a paid spot or anything else like this. I speak from curiosity. The same way I speak about, say, StreetLib or a platform like Blurb, I haven't been able to fully test those avenues, but from every indication, it looks like it's a great avenue to explore. And by the way, you go ahead, take a look at Laterpress. This is a referral link. I don't get paid for anything else like that. Go over to daylinks.com/Laterpress. But in their news today, they talked a little bit about rolling out public domain library. This week, we rolled out our public domain library, giving people a way to express classic literature online for free. We already have 60 plus titles available from authors like author Conan Doyle, Bram Stoker, H.G. Wells, Mary Shelley, and more. In the future, when we have our forum features available, we want Laterpress to become the best place on the internet for students, teachers, and all fans of literature to gather to discuss the classics. Look for new books to be added every week. Pretty freaking cool. Glad to see Laterpress starting to kind of, you know, really evolve and start to add more to their arsenal. Hey, I was just talking about Find a Way Voices. We're going to circle back around to them kind of indirectly because Spotify earlier this year acquired Find a Way, the parent company for Find a Way Voices. And at any rate, Spotify's CEO teases major push into audiobooks. Now, here's something that everybody really needs to pay attention to. They bought that property for good reason. And I think it's really awesome. And this piece is on Axios website. And part of what he was talking about, Spotify CEO Daniel Ek on Wednesday laid out plans to reach $100 billion in revenue in the next decade and to push into audiobooks to take on rival Amazon. Why it matters? Ek told Axios in an interview that the company's continued forays into audio businesses outside of music like podcasts and audiobooks will boost its long-term profits. Let me go ahead and just summarize the piece here for you. There have been some acquisitions that have been somewhat questionable. For instance, they spent about $100 million to acquire Joe Rogan and his podcast over there. And I hear that it's not bringing the results that they had looked for. But he's very forward thinking. He thinks about the long term game plan. Did they lose a lot of money up front? Yes. But in long term, having someone like that on the platform really raises the awareness. And so looking at why they're investing in what they're doing, they're looking at the game, big game plan. And I'm hoping that they leave Find a Way Voices as it should be, unless they plan on adding new like features and things like that. I don't have any insights on that one. And I haven't talked to the gang over at Find a Way Voices in a little bit. Where are you at, Will? I'm talking to Will Degas, the head of Find a Way Voices. He's probably busy. All right, moving further forward here. This actually comes from IngramSpark. Yeah. You can go ahead and waive those fees with a new coupon code, all right? That's sweet savings in all caps. And then you can set up your book for free. The offer expires on August the 31st. Code's not valid on previously submitted titles, and it's good for up to three. Count them, three free title uploads per account. And it cannot be used with free ISBNs. You must enter code sweet savings at the time of the upload. And that's all caps, no spaces. So there you go. There's a great code for you guys to keep working on. All right, I've been working with this company for a minute now, and I can't wait. I'm just chomping at the bit to share a little bit more about my process and working with Miblart. Now, Miblart actually has a very special offer for you right now that you can take advantage of. You could go ahead and use my affiliate code to get yourself wonderful graphic design for your book cover. And what I'm doing also is my Kindle Vella cover. I got two in the works. Super excited to share that with you guys. But if you'd like to go ahead and get yourself set up, go over to my affiliate link when you visit daylinks.com/Miblart. And here's how you're going to take 10% off on a custom book cover is use the code independence10. That's the number 10, independence10, as in Independence Day. All one word, all caps. You can get 10% off. This is good till July the 17th. I cannot recommend them enough. Really love them. I know I've gushed in the past about Fiverr. Love Fiverr and such like that. Still love you, Fiverr. But, you know, I'm starting to explore other avenues, and Miblart's definitely one of them. And let's go ahead and finish out the news segment. Just a friendly reminder, InkersCon, the digital conference, will be between July 16th to the 31st. It's right around the corner, and you can pick up yourself some tickets over at inkerscon.com. And use the code DALE22, all caps. We have to always shout our promo codes, I guess. I do have a talk on there, but there's so many other benefits to getting InkersCon access. And I will definitely be joining some of the roundtables that are going to be in the whole process of the event, because it's a way for me to get connected with other people. And speaking of connections, Authortube Writing Conference is right around the corner as well, between July 15th and July 17th. The opening starts at 3 p.m. This is not your traditional conference, all right? This is not your regular virtual summit where you go into one location. Believe it or not, it's like almost like a massive YouTube collaboration. and I'm super happy and excited to be the keynote speaker for this. I will be speaking at 3:30 right here on this channel. Do not miss out. We're going to be talking about pretty much help. I'm not getting any book sales. What do I need to do? And we're going to be discussing that a little bit more. You can find out more details over at AuthorTubeWritingConference.com. That's it for the news. Oh my gosh, that was a lot. Did I miss anything? Because if I miss something, I'm just at a loss at this point. And was there any piece of news that you enjoyed most? Love to hear from you.